Guys, this is Z.A.K here, finally with another video. And today I'm going to do an overview of my new Duratrax Evader EXT, the original EXT. I got this for free from my uncle's garage sale, and it was just a rolling chassis with tires and the servo and the shocks and everything. So yeah, let's get to it. So first of all, from the outside, it did come with a body. So I had to slap on my Rustler VXL's body, set a drill, two holes here, and besides, my uncle is crazy and he totally destroyed this truck, so I had to put my custom body mounts in from the Rustler or slash battery straps in, so that worked. And then in the front, I just had to drill two holes right here, and it was perfect with the Rustler body. So yeah, if I plan on getting another body for this, probably going to be a T4 body or another Rustler body, because this thing is in terrible shape, and Duratrax discontinued all of their two-wheel drive kits for some stupid reason, and I can't get any option parts or replacement parts or anything out there for this thing. But my uncle did include a full rear section for the truck and a full front section, so if I do break something, which I bet I won't, it'll be replaceable. And from the outside, yeah, there's the Rustler body, and I got the Proline Edge tires. They're really great tires. They're, I think, the M3. They're really soft. And it's got the old Duratrax dish wheels, and it's running bearings in the wheels. So yeah, it's pretty nice. It rolls pretty freely. And in the back, I did crack a wheel. The wheels that were on here were very old, and I got some T4 wheels, or T5, whatever you want to call it. And then I got some Proline Gladiators in the back. I love these tires. I run on my slash 4x4, which I have a ton of fun with. Gladiators just get this thing going anywhere, any off-road surface. And yeah, that's basically all that's for the outside. And the rear of my body is totally crap. I had some fiberglass tape jobs on this body, and they all pretty much sucked because there's holes burnt from it, because I used to do speed runs with my Rustler. Now I just got a better body. So yeah, pull this off. Yeah, this body's seen better days, guys. Yeah. So for now, what I'm running is this Traxxas shocks for the back and the front. These ones I bought from my friend for, I think it was like $4, maybe $5. His name is Kevin. He's on our channel too. Courtesy for the last video with the GoPro. Thanks a lot, man. And yeah, this thing's running his Titan 12T also, which in the garage sale I had some Rustler tires that were used, barely used, and I traded them for this. Great trade. This motor works amazing. And he loves the tires. And yeah, hobby shop. Oh wait, when I got this thing, the gear was fully stripped out, and the hobby shop only had one left. So yeah, it's pretty unlucky for me. So if I strip this one out, that'll suck. And by the way, this thing did come with a gear cover, so I have to be extra careful off-roading with this at my track. I get some dirt chunks in it once in a while. Nothing big. And I look everywhere and I try to find parts for this. Besides eBay, they don't have any, so I might just go there and get some stuff. And then my hobby shop has a ton of purple aluminum hop-ups for this thing, and they're like old little cardboard box bins that they have in their warehouse. And I could just pick up some really cheap aluminum parts. They're like $5 for like the rear camber link mount. And on their Duratrax's website from like 5 years ago, they were $70. I don't know why they're that expensive, guys. I don't know if I'm right about this. I looked, I just don't remember how much they costed. This thing's still running the CVDs. I think I told you that already. But yeah, I've been having bad luck with these. I've been losing a ton of CVD pins, so I had to make my own out of nails, and the nails I was using were really strong steel. And it never failed me again. As you can see, this pin coming out right here on this rear CVD. Yeah, that's pretty stupid. It's coming out. I'm probably going to have to buy some new ones for this thing. I'm probably going to get some MIPs if I have to. But for now, this thing's going to be brushed until I get my 17.5 motor on my B4 and put it in here when my B4 gets a motor upgrade. And yeah, originally this car, my uncle was pretty crazy. He had two of these Duratrax vehicles, and he got really bored, and he didn't have any of these things running. He thought they sucked, so he cut them in half, and he made a short course truck Evader. I thought it was pretty nifty, but yeah, he didn't include it all in one piece, so I just put it back to an Evader, Man, yeah, it runs perfectly fine. There's a little bit of chassis flex. Other than that, it runs really nice. I love running this thing. I'm going to take it racing on Friday. Not racing, just practice, because I don't know how this thing will run in a race. I just want to see how well it will do. And if it runs well, I'll race. And yeah, I'm going to race it on video for you guys. Yeah, the Shax's front shocks are on here on the front. Very good shock setup here. I don't know what oil is in it. It just came like this. Oh no, the rear shocks have no oil because the bodies are trashed. Yeah, it's very good suspension. And yeah, I'm running the XL5 ESC on this truck. And I'm running the TQI remote. Runs really nicely. That was my overview of the Duratrax Evader EXT. And I will be doing running videos of this truck soon. And I will be going to my track tomorrow. Hopefully I'll be getting some film of that. And yeah, guys, comment, rate, subscribe to see more videos from me. See y'all later.